Oh my god, this one time we're on tour, and this girl had like a kid. My assistant was like, you know, she talks about some pretty rough stuff. And this girl goes, oh, she'll be fine. She's seen Drag Race. Meanwhile, I'm out here talking about f***ing dead people. Hi, it's me, Trixie Mattel.
And I'm Katya.
And we are two queens who like to watch.
And today, we're watching the Netflix original animated series, Big Mouth, Season 4.
I think America is so afraid of sex, and this show is sort of like, yeah, we're not doing that.
Well, honey, puberty is disgusting.
Right, your body, your sexuality, your body changing, some of the only things that unify all of us.
It is the bridge.
Yeah.
It's bringing people together.
And spoiler alert, as usual.
Yeah, they go through puberty.
Yeah, baby. Sleepaway camp. No parents.
Did you go to sleepaway camps?
No.
Way.
I'm from so deep in the country that when we went to the Boy Scout camp, it was closer to the big city. I was like, you call this camping? At my house, we have an outhouse, bitch.
The boy shower rules. It's so interactive.
Have you ever showered in a communal shower like that?
I have never, not once, ever.
Well, this was the team. I was one of the only people in like 10th grade and beyond who was not in some sort of athleticism. And if you were an athlete, you used like the varsity shower room. It was me, every kid with glasses, and like the carjacker. Which was actually a gayer experience, because then it was like me and one guy alone in the shower.
Weird. The only thing that's worse than weird is small.
What?
When they see your little rat nose, they're gonna rip you apart.
Were you afraid if people saw your dick that they were gonna say you had a small dick?
No, I got pantsed once, but that was the only time I was ever, like, naked with God.
Yeah. I wasn't afraid of people seeing my dick.
Oh, he's got a giant wiener.
I mean, it's... But I also was, like, soft. What can you really tell about anybody's wiener when it's soft? I mean, come on.
Not much.
Not much.
Milk, lemonade.
Dude.
Around the corner, fudge is made.
Oh, my God.
Forgot.
Straight people are fucking... wild.
I mean, gay people are too, but they don't really do this stuff. There was a straight guy who used to show us his asshole. Nobody asked for that.
I'm so tired. I mean, I am judging them and I have been peed on, so I guess I need to like...
Yeah, but that's different.
Now I have reached my limit with the boy shower.
I'm very gay in that I don't like gross stuff. Except for all the gross things I say all the time.
Yeah, all the time, literally.
It's only fine if it comes from my mouth. Or goes in it. Caution ahead, watch out for pepperoni-sized nipples and LGBTQ stuff.
My pepperoni nipples are so cooked.
Oh my god.
This is like giving me flashbacks like Ren and Stimpy, like the grotesqueness.
I love it here. You should see if Aiden needs any sunscreen on his d**k and ass.
I don't want to be gross, but that voice is hot. But you
gotta be cool.
It's hot! Whatever!
You're like an amazing digger.
You stupid turd!
What the hell?
How many times do I have to tell you I'm a girl? We're not supposed to be strong and good at work.
Me pulling my own suitcase to the airport.
Yeah, oh, I get it. You guys are digging us a giant toilet. Thanks.
Hope we don't
piss on you. Okay. Not the pee again.
69!
Here we go!
Nobody pisses on Wallog Puglio's puppy!
She hit their dick with the shovel.
That was fantastic.
Poor queen.
You think that was hot? You should taste my mouth.
Wow. Is it possible this party could actually be good?
Oh, it's not good. It's perfect. This is officially better than the time I saw Eric Stone Street fall down a flight of stairs.
Welcome. I have to say, I hated for a while when gay people were like coming on the scene and filmed to TV, that gay people were always being portrayed as sympathetic.
Yeah.
I prefer when the gay people are monsters and things, because mama, that's the tea. The gay friend no one can get rid of.
That's the truth.
All right, we're at summer camp here, and we have a little coming out moment.
This is Natalie. She'll be in our bunk this summer. She is trans, so everybody just f***ing be cool.
Hey, everyone.
Wait, Gabe?
It's Natalie, actually.
That is so cool.
Yes, queen. Go off, girl boss. Pussy hat slay.
Hey, Natalie.
Hey, Jackson.
This show really jumped out the window, and it went from being a comedy to a documentary. Slay, that's the boots realness. Tee the house down. Yes, Scott, it's the worst.
The worst.
I'm not even going to explain what it is, because if you don't know what that is, it's you.
If you know, you know.
This is going to sound weird, but when I started going through puberty, it was like this monster showed up.
All right, buddy. We're going to give you broad, hairy shoulders and a high
f***ing ass.
Oh, and you're gonna get more pussy than a no-kill animal shelter.
No, get away from me, you horny psycho. I think maybe I'm gay.
Yeah, I did kind of think you were gay.
So did I. But then I sang this duet with the ghost of Freddie Mercury.
Sure, as one does.
By the way, I think I had the opposite experience. Before I knew what gay was, I thought, oh, if I like boys, maybe I'm supposed to be a girl.
Really?
But then I did this, so who knows?
I just know I hate you and what you're doing.
What's your f***ing problem, kid?
I don't know. I just know I hate you and what you're doing to my body.
Nobody likes puberty. That's why they made the f***ing show.
I decided I should go on hormone blockers.
New kids on the hormone blockers.
Oh, my God. I don't think when I was this age, I even knew what a trans person was.
That's the thing. Programs like this don't make people anything, but they give them the vocabulary to know what it is in the real world and not feel disarmed by it. You know what I mean?
Yes, I do.
In a morning way.
Yes. What is up with...
What about if we get a tampon up in there?
No. No way. I am not ready to stick something up there. What if it gets lost and never comes out?
Ooh, like Daniel Dave Lewis in an acting role.
Or what if you, like, eat some...
Daniel Dave. I love
that. Oh, my God. Look at her swimming.
Oh, Lord.
Maybe the children will be nice.
Maybe the children will be nice.
Who would wear a pad in the water?
Yeah. Oh, it even has a period that big, am I right?
Yeah, mine's just like a Skittle that falls out, and I just throw it away.
I just a Skittle that falls out.
Someone out! It's creating a vortex!
Everybody out of the way! Come on, guys.
Hey, how's camp going for you?
Absolutely terrible, you.
That's a nightmare.
Oh, perfect.
Hey, Mr. Man.
Literally my singing voice.
Literally, yeah.
Am I a bowl of soup for human
Get off the stage, soup.
Ran into the woods.
Have you been heckled? Like, really heckled?
Well, they're always asking me to take my top off. No. I've had people too drunk to be there, but not
that's different.
Anti-Trixie, hate your jokes, etc. Yeah. And I've had plenty of people walk out because they were offended, which I take as a job well done. But I've never been heckled like, hey, get off the stage, I don't like it.
You're not doing too good up there and I'm bored.
Have you been heckled during any of your programs?
No.
Devon broke up with her because she wouldn't give him a hand job. Huh? It's very upsetting.
Who's doing hand jobs? You doing hand jobs?
Do I?
I've never given a hand job in my entire life.
I love it.
Boyfriend in the kitchen at 11.
What about us?
Get to the point, Allie. I'm a busy lady.
She means it can feel really f***ing good to get f***ed.
Hell yeah.
I mean, I don't think all kids talk like this.
No, but this is the absolute gist of the activities that are taking place.
Ugh, what is it about the last night of camp that gets everyone so horned up?
All right, so it's the last day of camp and the kids are really like last ditch effort. Flirt, go for the pickup lines, try to get a girl. What about people who would like, it's the last day of camp and people would cry? I'll do you one better.
Wow.
What about that
very cool
girl who would scream when the teacher turned the lights out? I hope every girl who ever screamed when the teacher turned the lights out is dead.
Keep bringing just like I this would be my first time, like, kissing a boy, and it just feels scary.
Yeah.
Were you scared first time you kissed a boy?
I mean, looking back, it was, it was not like, like most gay people, I don't think my first kiss was like optimal safety. Optimal, like, if my body goes missing, will people know where I am?
Were you turning tricks in a truck stop bathroom?
Yes.
No!
Oh, my first kiss was delightful.
Who would you kiss? Who did you kiss?
Well, I also blew him, too.
Wait, in gay world, what is the base? First base,
okay. I pressed first kiss. Second base, fisting.
Second base, poppers. Yeah, poppers with fisting. Third base, P&P, ceiling, suspension, hooks through the skin, and the home base is necrophilia.
I'm gonna finger milk. As God is my witness, I'm gonna wear him like a ring pop.
My dad's friend, Bob Reedy, has a statue of a finger in his nightstand.
Shut the up, milk!
Yes! That character is so fierce.
My first kiss was with a troll named Myron. He had a flat ass and buck teeth. He could eat me out through a tennis racket. He dated for 8 years.
Wouldn't that be the dream job to get one of these monster parts? You just to show up and say some crazy
In 1969, sexy hair, whoop whoop, all the queers got to go to Stonewall. And Marsha P. Johnson, she threw out the first pitch.
Work queen.
And then the laws started to change, and now we have pride parades, drag race.
Oh my God! Wait, come back! Do you think that's supposed to be RuPaul?
Yes. Of course it is.
And look at the forehead.
I know, that's what I'm saying. It's amazing.
And to her left is Dora the Explorer. And on the other side, who is that?
It's you. You.
Oh, I guess that's me. Yeah, sure. Except those men in the front row? No. So those men are not at the event. Those are 13-year-old girls. Sorry about it.
We have to hand job. And if I don't want to, I'm approved.
Okay. My friends are full of Broderick hasn't even kissed a boy.
Oh.
And besides, handjobs are only fun if both of us are into it.
So it's okay to wait?
Of course.
Let's just take the pressure off, circle a date on the calendar 6 months from now, and if you're not ready by then, I'll kill myself.
Can we still make it? Sure.
Maybe after that.
I'm going to stop you right there. I would say one in every 10 gay sexual encounters is fun. And the other ones are only life-affirming. You've got a lot of anxiety about first-time anything. This isn't just a teenager thing. This isn't every age of your life thing. Because when we talk about sexual freedom, we often talk about do whatever you want. But that also includes
not
don't do whatever you want. I was literally taught abstinence in school. I had to sign a contract saying I won't have sex. And I did keep the contract.
She's a man of her word.
She's a man of her word.
Can't wait to you off on my timetable.
Jim. Completely me.
Can't wait to engage in sex when it's convenient for me.
Oh my.
There was a scandal in my dad's 7th grade class. The kids were f***ing on Snapchat.
I'm so happy I never sent news to my face in my whole life.
Never. Never, not one. Never one time, ever.
Well, this is a tasty cake pop.
Look at that hair! Oh my God! More representation for us.
I know, seriously. I feel very seen and heard.
Mom! So, you're just gonna leave without saying goodbye?
We've got a conservative mother who thinks that being gay is a choice.
But I just don't think two boys should be baking together.
Mom.
I mean, if I had a kid who was gay, I know how much harder it's going to be, so I might read them for filth about it. Like, so you're gay, huh? Well, that was a choice. You really just made your situation worse.
I love it when people insist on, the choice to be gay. As if anyone would do that. I don't understand you. I knew when I was 2. Dead ass.
Pour the cement on it. She sure.
Pour the cement on it.
I know you just can't stand the idea of you making these sinful choices and baking in hell for all eternity because Jesus is watching.
That's the killer with gay people who are obsessed with their moms.
How's your relationship with your mom?
Fine. She couldn't be less impressed with me in any form of it. Drag isn't impressive to her. Being gay is not even interesting to her.
Call me when you start riding dirt bikes, you pansy.
Yeah, she's not impressed. I'm just calling to say hi. She's like, I'm kind of watching something. My mom does not need, she's like, still alive? Great. See you Thanksgiving. She doesn't need more than that.
7th graders.
That's right.
Guess we're on the prowl now.
All right, so there's a little bit of a makeout party, and it's the 7th graders being welcomed to school by the 8th graders.
How's a man even to choose?
The same way we choose everything. Da, 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 da.
Oh, Netflix.
Let's see what girls are suggested for us.
We know everyone can see us.
And that's part of the thrill.
There's no one popular.
She's my best friend.
And I'm a little shorter than her.
And together, we're making sustained eye contact with you guys.
Yeah, we are.
Hell yeah. That is so stupid.
Nick and Andrew and their 7th grade snacks? Yum, yum.
Yeah.
Relax, babe.
This haircut, by the way, short little bangs, weird side spit curl, and the back of the hair is just a nutsack. I love it.
I'd totally be down a French kiss, Spanish fly, Dutch oven, fart in your mouth.
Misha, slow your roll.
Well, then.
Spanish fly, Dutch oven, fart in your mouth.
I mean, this show is shocking me, and I'm pretty disgusting. I'm the worst person I know.
Classic 8th grade makeout party.
Hi.
Ruth Bader Ginsburg. I love it.
Can I ask, what are you?
Gianni Versace. It was a couple's costume. Aiden was going to be Andrew Cunanan. And we had the cinnamon stick with cooked spaghetti.
For Donatella, of course. It looks just like Aiden.
Oh, my God. Not done.
Still goes to no
good. A cinnamon stick with cooked spaghetti.
Work.
I don't even know. Oh my God.
This mom's just making show so weird is about rotten. Relationship.
It's rotted. It's rotted. In the best way.
Matthew's hell. Okay. Is this supposed to scare me?
No.
but this is...
Harvey Fierstein.
You gotta choose, Matthew, or they both die.
His homophobic mom or his boyfriend?
So oh, not that mom.
You're not even getting a funeral. I'm putting you in the Nutribullet and pouring you down the bathroom sink.
Not the Nutribullet.
No one's gonna die, no matter who I choose. Not in this deeply flawed play, or in real life. Thank you, Beelzebubby.
For a stirring performance?
No, for giving me perspective.
So good.
This show has everything. Periods. Talking vaginas, hand jobs, monsters, summer camp, gay
Jesus,
homophobes.
So that's it. That's the end of the show.
Check out season 4 of Big Mouth on Netflix.
On Netflix.